Respiratory therapists really work in all aspects that deal with a patient's ventilation, perfusion, oxygenation. We deal with patient issues for individuals who come into the ER who might need advanced mechanical ventilation, all the way up to dealing with premature neonates who are currently receiving treatment in the neonatal and intensive care unit. Our Bachelor of Science in Respiratory Care degree advancement program is a bridge program for individuals who have received either an associate's or an associate of applied science, and they're looking to transition from being a registered respiratory therapist into a baccalaureate registered respiratory therapist.
I knew I wanted to get my bachelor's to better myself and to be able to say I have a bachelor's in my field of respiratory care. It helps you grow as a person, it helps you grow professionally and be able to present and speak and know more in the field of respiratory care.
I wanted to earn a bachelor's degree within respiratory care because I seen the need for advancement. Had graduated with an associate's, I was practicing at the bedside at a very high level, but I seen within the industry that there was going to be a need for bachelor degree.
Our program is 100% online. We offer 11 classes taught by 3 different full-time faculty members and approximately 10 adjunct faculty members. And we offer 2 different 7-week sessions every semester.
The Boise State DAP program stood out to me because it's very flexible, which was what I liked a lot about the online learning portion. It's very affordable, which was surprising to me because it is such a great program. Being able to be in California where I live and work and network with so many other students who are from all over the country was truly the best part.
Many of our programs are still at an associate or an associate of applied science level, so it's more and more important for us to stay competitive with other professions.
I remember going through my associate's program very focused on bedside care and clinical care with patients, and then when you get into this Boise State DAP program, you look at quality improvement projects, you get to look at teaching and leadership. So it kind of took it a step further of things that you didn't really have time to focus on trying to learn how to become a practicing practitioner, but the DAP program was able to bring me a step further and to look at the whole picture. So not just patient care, not just direct patient care, but organizationally what patient care looks like.